ผู้ยืมมอได้ชัวทตาใจเนชเรลกงทรกูมอนอกุลุเบหัวเทปอว่ากุตุนจีเน่เฮารุ่นดงอุระเวงเซงแคลิฟอร์เนียเตเชมิกามอนอในสิ่งเรื่องจ้าเชลซอสือของเตเต้นามัวนันดาวกุเกียรีกุยอดเปละทาไฮจอไฮจอจะซอสืออัวมัวฝึงชัวโตเนเชอร์เดอเทเปแต่ชีวันได้ชับเลยเนาะวันได้ชับเลยเนาะนู่นอไปถูกตีมงเจอช่วงว่าตาต่อเรามุดเติร์จ่ายงหม้อเติร์จ่าเราจะเกี่ยชิงยานยังเจอรีนือเตาถ่าเชนยอดเราซิสกิวคาวน์ตี้คอร์ทเฮาส์ตาชินอหนือตาต่อแล้วตาต่อคะแนนเตาเราหนือหน่อยกูจะเป็นลันดอเจอช่วงถ่าวันได้ชอบเลยกูจะเป็นลันถ่าให้จอสอสื่อยอดเราหูหนอเอกวันกูจะเจอช่วงเราตาชินอโอเคอะไรวะยอดจังวะไฮเซอร
์ไอ
Hey, welcome back. This is your fourth day. New tip blow,
lor. Officially, but I haven't eaten 5 days.
Got you. Don't know. Mochi nu the hot. They got young nu one day nu or the two hotter.
Yeah.
Ewa, when Ia, this is so nu, Gusan, I got Hana, got put okay, nu no, got put chai pla, got jolly gala. Here, put a pay one day.
Okay. Gui Halumika, Today, today I got very, very angry because Takusha, when I woke up, called Siskiyou County Sheriff deputies. They came out and they said, I have bad news for you, sir. We got a letter from the state. They said you can't be in front of the courthouse because you don't have any court business. If you stay here and you're still here by 8, we're going to arrest you for trespassing.
Wow.
Yeah, that's you. I said, I know my rights. I know my First Amendment rights. I have a right to peacefully protest on public property. If I'm not blocking entryways, if I'm not blocking stairs, if I'm not saying hateful, violent speech. And this is a state courthouse, so they don't allow you to protest if that protest is trying to influence a current court proceeding.
Okay.
Well, I'm not protesting a current court proceeding. I don't know what's going on in there. I'm doing this to get federal investigations for a person who got murdered. So I said, can I see that letter from the state? He said, I don't have
to. Did they give you the letter?
No.
He just said it.
They just said it. They didn't provide any letter. And I knew that they were trying to stop me.
Intimidate you? Are they trying to intimidate you?
I believe they really were trying to intimidate me. But It was the sergeant, and there was this deputy that came. If you saw the deputy, you know the type of MacGyver person he is. He ain't y'all 20 years MacGyver. He ain't power. Y'all auto bull versus what? Two of them versus me because my people they're patrolling for my safety. So I said okay, because if I say something or if we do something and you guys end up shooting me, it's both of your words against mine. So then I said okay, can I go protest at the sidewalk? They said, no, that sidewalk is still state property, it's still court property. I said, that's bullshit. State property is public property and I have a right to be there. But he said, no, you're there, we're going to arrest you for trespassing. And I said, you know what, I'm not scared to get arrested, but there's no other witnesses but me. So then when we got down to that conversation, my people showed up and I said, don't worry, this happened, we're going to go over there. And then we're going to talk to our legal team. So then I called all our people, and then they said they're going to talk to our legal team. And then our lawyers called them and said, we demand that letter. And they didn't provide the letter. So that
they did not provide the letter. They just threatened you with words.
Threatened me with words, and I knew it was a false threat because they can't threaten my constitutional rights.
And that is a sheriff? That is a Siskiyou County sheriff and a sergeant?
Yeah. Siskiyou County Sheriff, the people who've been harassing us this whole time. So then our lawyer said, you go and you protest right in front of the sign on the sidewalk. So I did. Me and a few of my people, we did. We came strong. And then the sergeant came on. He said, Zerg, what are you doing? You're still on this private property. I'm going to have to arrest you for trespassing. And I said, officer, sergeant, I'm ready to get arrested. Come and arrest me. He didn't come arrest me. You know what he did?
He did not.
He went to go talk to his boss, Sheriff Peru, and then he came back 10 minutes later, and he came and talked to me. I was on the sidewalk. He said, okay, I talked to my boss. He said that you can protest on the sidewalk right here. And I said, your boss, your sheriff, has no right to tell me how I can exercise my constitutional right. He can't say, oh, you can go right there, because there's nothing in the law that says I can't be right here if I'm following the right way. If I'm not, like I said earlier, not blocking anything, not inciting hateful speech, et cetera, et cetera. And I said, where's the letter? Is it your boss that's been telling you this, or is it the supposed state, a letter from the state? And then the sergeant said, I'm not going to argue semantics. I'm not going to argue he said, she said. And I said, that's the whole legal system. It's words. Whatever you say.
Now, who is this authority in the state that sent the letter? Like, is that the attorney general? Is that the governor? Is that who is it?
Exactly. They just said it was a letter from the state. So okay. Then the comic club and one, well, you ain't your father. They small and all. Bit Jay Han, we're very smart, we're very educated. I speak English better than the white people. Okay, so when they said that, what do? We made Facebook Live, and we tagged Governor Newsom, and we said the UC County Sheriff's Department said that the state of California sent them a letter to remove me from the premises or arrest me for trespassing. I want to know, Governor Newsom and all the state government in Sacramento, why did you send this letter to stop and impede my constitutional rights? And if they get that letter, it's going to be either, oh, we did send that letter, but we're going to get a lot of heat, or they're going to be like, we have no idea what you're talking about. And then I would say, well, you guys get to come to Siskiyou County and see what's going on. So then these Mika'a'ako people, they have no idea what they're messing with. So then you know what happened after that? Our lawyer called LaRue directly. And then once that happened, I got the okay to come back to the same place I was before they kicked me out.
At the front of the courthouse?
At the front of the courthouse.
Wow. So you have to fight just to be there in a public courthouse.
Yeah. Public courthouse. We're not doing anything wrong. I'm not protesting.
It's not a private property.
It's not private property. It's paid for by taxpayer dollars. If you're homeless, you come sleep here. You know? So
wow. What a day for you. I'm sorry to hear.
That's why I'm okay. I have all this energy because I'm so mad. Like, I'm so mad because they think that we're a bunch of stupid people. They think that we're just Hmong people who just got out of the jungle. And I told them that. You have no idea what you're messing with.
Okay. Now, let me ask in Hmong, and then I'm going to say English for a few things today. First of all, check on who not. Is there any public health people come and check on your health?
No, no more. But you ain't check. What you check? They said they couldn't make it. You know, it's quite a coincidence that these people try to kick me out and deny me my First Amendment rights, and then public health isn't going to come check me today. It's like, is this a coordinated effort by the local government to deny me my rights and make sure that I actually do die and so they can blame me for it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that's the case, but it's a little suspicious, like that.
Mm-hmm. So, have you been eating at all?
No.
Okay.
The Mika'a'ako people here, they know what I'm doing. They've been spreading rumors. Oh, that guy's been eating Big Macs. Oh, that guy's been drinking protein shakes. So now I haven't been eating anything.
Okay. But you've been drinking. Like water. Drink water and Gatorade, you said?
Water, Gatorade, Pedialyte. I need electrolytes because in 2-3 days I'll faint and maybe die. So I can't get it. Yeah, because they kicked me out. Courthouse, courtyard, you know? There's a roof. So then, they kicked me out to the sidewalk. No shade. The sunlight, very hot, 100+ degrees, and we said that they try to burn us out of our valley, and they're trying to burn us out of the courthouse. Yeah, they see me, and half the Mika'a'ako Club people come and talk to me and say, we support you, because what they're doing to you is the same thing they did to us, because we're the wrong kind of Mika'a'ako Club people, and we're the kind of Mika'a'ako Club people that don't have any money. And so half the community is with us, and the other half is trying to destroy us.
ไอ้นู่นน่ะกูนูก็ขอจริงๆที่อีเนาะก็ที่หายไปเมย์ขอกูยังนู่นน่ะเลยก็มั่วลอเยอร์เรพรีเซนต์ก็ที่หรอคือจะเป็นตาช็อกคอมมูนิตี้ยังไงทีมอีทูลอเยอร์ Okay, eh, ta shi na ka tu lawyer la ya ne cha ta cha na ka pu ta mo lang to reach out mo to state level tia mo to federal level la cha authority la ya la cha na chu o mo feng xuo hai cha ka na hai tia ta ta mo i tu mong yong mo lo mo ta cha hai cha cha ke chi to zai ke yan yang na pu mo lang to wo khana
The lawyer is going to come talk to me in a couple days, but pu ma ha ka ta ta
Will you make in couple day? Ka pu okay ma, yo nong zi na, ka chi na mo le na.
Well, I am ready to move off the end. If they don't want to meet our demands, we can move off the end. We can have a time.
We can have a time. We can have a time. We can have a time.
We can have a time. You can survive for 2 months.
Really?
Yeah. People have gone on hunger strikes and they last 50, 60 days. Some people last 80 days. So okay. We can have a time. Off the end.
Hunger strike, when you start, it's easy. That's she, when you're going to end it, it's going to be more difficult.
That's why I'm doing it, nobody's gonna know what we're going through. So that is what I'm prepared to do. They made me a leader of the young people, so I'm willing to sacrifice for our people.
A Mondu, eh? Got Yali Jam, Mondu, Pumulin, Tokan Yon, got Wakalua.
Yeah, I didn't mean to make them have a hell in the dark. I have people watching me 24/7 because I've already got a few threats. So they drive around and they stare at me, and I know half these people don't like what I'm doing. So then my people are worried. But then we ain't worry about white people. We don't worry about maybe a sheriff, a board supervisor, chai ka mom tinye and po hata hai. Yung yung ipo pan kamo to ay ta ha mo temi chupa. I dream
that, and
that's a real possibility. So they can say, "Hey, come on, as Hmong people killed each other. We had nothing to do with it."
Is that something you think? Is that going in your brain, or you just?
If I was border supervisor, if I was a sheriff, uh-huh. I would try to frame it as these people are evil. They're killing each other. But in reality, I paid a Hmong person $100,000 to be assassin. So that's the real
so,
problem.
Are you fear?
No. If they hurt me while I'm on hunger strike, it only helps our cause. So it helps us even better.
So you're not fear of being arrested, not fear of being threatened and maybe even in a harm way or even lose your life. Not at all.
No, because our young people chose me as a leader. I can't be afraid if I'm a leader. Then the people who follow me are going to be afraid. So that's how I lead.
Okay. Now, another question is this is your fourth day, obviously. What's the difference today from the first, second, third day? What's different today?
My head was foggy. I wasn't as sharp as I usually am. So then that's why I didn't think to record it because I just woke up. I was weak. My head was way more foggier than usual, and they knew exactly when to attack me as soon as I woke up.
Mentally.
So then I told the people, you guys need to come here and be my brain for me while my brain starts going,
Are the sheriff came back? Deputy and the sergeant came back and do anything? Or anyone at all today? Anyone visit you?
They don't want to even look at me. They are very scared. They had no idea that our Hmong people were so smart and so willing to take the fight, and they didn't know that the whole community would come out. So,
All right, so the last question is, ก็ขอแพลนหูนอดูก็ขอแพลนหูนอปวดเป๋าลีว่าเป๊ะเปล่าหูเท่ารอเลยso เลยก็จึงย้อนก็รู้หอเพี้ยจึงย้อนรู้กู้ซื้อis your plan changed from 4 days ago or is your plan still the same like you are going for the end
I'm definitely going for the end, but the plan has changed a little bit, in which, not in a different way, not in a worse way, but in a better way. We're like, okay, they actually tried to stop me from using my constitutional rights. I'm still going to go on a hunger strike. I'm still going to die if I have to, but now our people were much more aware. Cameras 24/7. As soon as I'm not even going to speak to police anymore, I'm going to exercise my right to, remain silent.If I have any issues, if they even talk to me about something that I find suspicious, I call the lawyer right away.
Okay.
That's the only thing that changed.
Okay. Well, with that said, is any mainstream media visited you?
No, just local news, Medford.
Like Channel 12? Like?
I think so. Yeah, Channel 12.
Is that KNVN?
Yeah, they didn't visit me, but they did do the interview the first day of our protest. I think you guys probably seen it. If you haven't, go look it up.That's when I declared my hunger strike, but no media since then has talked to me. Public mental health was actually a Hmong guy that came and talked to me. He works for the government.
Okay.
And he came to interview me to make sure that my mental health was there. They want to make sure that I'm not crazy for doing the hunger strike. And then after he interviewed me, I asked him, like, you think I'm crazy? He said, you're the most sane person I've ever talked to.
Ah, okay. So,
yeah.
Okay. Well, nu na ne, gu zhe bei lu huan de personally, ye tu mong na, bei lu ge ge li. And as a journalist, I want to ask you a blank question. Is that your goal is still asking for federal investigation and that Sheriff LaRook remove from the office or resign?And also release the camera of the deputy or the officer who shot the Hmong guy, which we don't know the name. Is that still your goal?
I'll tell you the goal is a little long. We do have a list of demands.
Okay, can we hear it?
Yeah, sure. The first demand is an independent federal investigation into the shooting of our Hmong brother. The releasing of body cams, obviously, is one of them. We want an independent federal investigation into the Siskiyou County Sheriff's Office for using discriminatory and racist tactics against our Hmong people, against Piletone Lao. We ain't pa Piletone Lao, we know our rights, but Piletone Lao, they don't know their rights, so they harass our old people. That's why we're pissed off right now. So we want a federal independent investigation into Siskiyou County's discriminatory and racist tactics against us, discrimination.And they've actually used volunteers to come and destroy private property. And we know that they're like white supremacist racists. So we demand investigation into that. And and also Sheriff LaRue's resignation. But we want them to say, hey, we didn't use white supremacist groups as volunteers. Then we demand the release of these identities for transparency because they acted in according with public officials. So they should be in the public record. And if they don't want to release that, then it works twofold, okay? If we demand that, they have to release these people or they have to admit that they use white supremacists. If they release the identities, nobody's going to want to volunteer with them again. They're like, hey, we did this for you guys, and now everybody knows who we are. So if we're thinking like that, we're thinking in multiple layers. And we demand a federal independent investigation of the board of supervisors and their tyrannical rule against us, their discriminatory tactics, and the lifting of the water ban. I told you about the water ban last time, right?
Yes. Can you tell us again?
Their water ban only affects the subdivision that us Hmong and Chinese people live in.
Ah.
Our lawyer told us, Kasa, we only represent 2% of the Sa growth in this county. But it's us Hmong and it's us Chinese they're targeting. If you look at the law, the ordinance, all the roads that they say ban water, those are the roads that surround our subdivision. Those are the roads that surround our community. If you go any other community, if you go to the white community, they can deliver 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 gallons of water. If you go to just a little bit over there, they get all the water. They also shut off the main well we use, and they know we don't have any wells
in
there.
And that is one of your demand. That's one of your demand. Okay.
Our demand is the lifting of the water ban, yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, you know, let me ask you this. The other question I want to know now is that Let me speak in Hmong first, okay? Now, Guzer, Gusapo, Haitia, Yo Olika, Pe Hmong, Haitia, Ta Kung Munyo, Got a saw mutao ya, okay? Kung Munyo saw, saw la yon, okay? A Yo Olika, a got like your chung fu, be got like your chung fu, state, like a federal, Tilly, you are lot dow, Cheng Doka Hotang Mung, a Cheng Ga, Toy Yung Mo, Jaw, Lerma, Lot Dow, Yatang Mung, Kahai Ga, how? What is the solution you want? How? What would they do? What would they do to like, okay, Zerk, let's stop right there and we will do A, B, and C. Now, what would be acceptable for you?
Federal government come here and they fulfill all our demands. That's it. I told you what the demands are. I want them to investigate, because I know as soon as they investigate, they're going to find so much corruption. They're going to find so many skeletons in the closet.
And if they do that, if the federal government come in and say, okay, Zerk, we promise we will look at this thoroughly and we will investigate this, then you stop strike.
That's a good question, Ted. If they do come in here, I know they're going to find a lot of unconstitutional discriminatory things. I really believe that because, you know, I know what I'm talking about. I will stop. Okay. But nobody's paying attention to us right now because we're Hmong. You know, we're not Chinese, not Japanese. We don't have much power.
And, you know, my unprofessional opinion, not even an official journalist, is that, you know, at least can save your life. You can fight for another day if they do that. I mean, to me, it's innocent idea of saving your life.
They're not going to let me die in front of American Courthouse. It's going to embarrass them nationally. It's going to embarrass the county. It's going to embarrass California. This is a brand new courthouse. They just built it. It opened up a month ago. $20-30 million paid for by our tickets, by the way. But they're not going to let me die. They're going to come in here and say, this guy's on a hunger strike. What's going on? They shot one of those people. We just signed an anti-Asian discrimination bill. Governor Newsom just signed it. So we're like, are you just signing it to appease us? To say, okay, yeah, we're paying attention, but we're not going to do anything. Are you actually going to do something?
Do you hope to hear from Governor Newsom's office? Do you hope?
I hope to hear all the way up from Vice President Kamala Harris. These are the people who say that they're serious about minority rights, they're serious about protecting us Asians.
You mentioned Vice President Kamala Harris and even President Biden and Governor Newsom hear about your case. Do you know if they hear about your case?
They might be aware of what's going on, but I think Don Trump, they're trying to wait to see Yaku. They want to see Yaku if I'm going to do it all the way or if I'm going to quit. But I'm not going to quit. They might not care now at day four, but at day 40, they're going to pay attention.
All right. So now his final question is, you will fight until they come to solve your problem or you will die for the cause, according to what you told me yesterday.
This is my work. This is what I know I have to do. My people are depending on me. And they said, you know what? I've never seen a Hmong person ever do this for us. And I told them, you've seen the first person. And now after me, you'll see thousands do the same thing. Because at the end of the day, what I'm really doing is I want to tell our Hmong people, this is what we can be. We can be people.
In fact, thousands of people watching you live right now and thousands will watch later.
You know what? Just walk the walk. All you need to do is take that one step and it's easy. It's very easy. I was scared to do this too. I'm a hunger striker. Like I go on a hunger strike. I don't have any money. I don't have any power. I've only been here 9 months, but I knew that nobody else would do it. And I wanted to see somebody to actually do this and say, hey, you know, Hmong people are actually proud to fight for their rights. So I said, fine, if nobody's going to do it, I'll do it. And I know in my heart that since I did it, all our people, your young people, or most of them, they're going to be like, hey, man, if you can do that, I can do that. And that's what it's all about. So you guys just walk the walk, Haza. Just walk the walk.
Okay. Hope you stay strong and hope they come and rescue you. Solve the problem. Easy. Solve the problem and rescue you.
If they don't come and I die, then I know my Hmong people will rise up and it'll be a new age of Hmong people. If I live, same thing. But if I die, I also know that that would just help us even more. Okay. And I'm willing to accept that.
All right, well, กูต้องเช็คนกอลีนอนหุนอเอว่ากูจะต้องเช็คนกอตะกีเนอะเอเช่ก็หันย้อนลีกา hopefully ก็เดี๋ยวหุนอก็จะช่วยมุ่งชอก็เสริมข้อมูลจีด้าเดอเจอเลยน้อย
Yeah, ก็ป้าบอกเต็มใจกูสว่ากูทุกข์ all day, I've been angry all day, I've been talking all day, but I don't feel hungry. I'm okay. Maybe tomorrow, I'll get shit done. But I have more than me. You never know what's gonna happen every day.
Okay. So if anything emergency, you know, have one of your people call. Maybe
They'll call you. They're around me 24/7, and we'll see what happens. Yeah.
Well, thank you, and we again wish you stay strong.
But cha cha, she lo she pa, me don't know.
Okay. Olina, ocho bye.
Cha.